Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Today we continue our study of 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. We're reading from, we're going to look at 1 John first, amen. 1 John chapter 4, amen. Verse 1, 2, 3. In Thessalonians, we're going to read about the man of sin being revealed, amen. The son of perdition. But before we get into that, we just want to look at the scripture in 1 John chapter 4. It says, "Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God. Because many false prophets have gone out into the world. Hereby know ye the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesseth that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is of God. And every spirit that confesseth not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is not of God. And this is that spirit of an antichrist, whereof ye have heard that it should come, and even now already is it in the world." Amen. So John is saying that we must try the spirits whether they are of God. How do we try the spirits? Amen. The Bible says, try the spirits whether they are of God. Amen. We use the word of God to try the spirits. Amen. If someone's got the right spirit, if someone is born again and full of the Holy Ghost, they'll agree with every word of God. Amen. But when you see someone fussing and fighting and arguing and questioning and doubting and disbelieving the word of God, and you look at their lifestyle, amen, they have a form of godliness, but they deny the power thereof. They look religious, they act religious, they talk religious. But when you give them the word test, when you take the word of God and you take their doctrine, when you take the message that they preach, and you examine it by the word, and you try the spirit by the word of God, friend, you will see that if they don't confess that Yahweh God was made manifest in the man Christ Jesus, that Yeshua HaMashiach, the Lord Jesus Christ, is both God and man. He's the prophet, he's the king, he's the priest. Amen. The Son of God, the Son of Yahweh God, prophet, the Son of David, king. Amen. The Son of Man, priest. Amen. Friend, if they don't confess that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh, if they confess not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh, they are not of God. And the Bible says in verse 3, this is that spirit of an antichrist. Of an antichrist. Whereof you have heard that it should come, and even now already is it in the world. Notice in the book of Genesis, when Abel was born, Cain was there. Amen. Look, Israel was going to the promised land. We had Moab there. When Yeshua was born, you find when he called his disciples, Judas was amongst those disciples. Amen. Judas healed the sick. Judas raised the dead. Judas cast out devils. But at the Last Supper, friend, when Yeshua turned to Judas after Judas had dipped his bread in the sop, Yeshua said to him, "What you do, do it quickly." And the Bible says that Judas walked out, and it was night. And the Bible goes on to say, and Satan entered Judas. Amen. You see, when you give place to the devil has a legal right to possess you. And the Bible says it's coming a time when the son of perdition, the man of sin, that wicked one, will be revealed. Amen. Let's go to 2 Thessalonians. Amen. Amen. You see, Nimrod was a type of the Antichrist. Nimrod was rebellious. He was a mighty hunter before the Lord. Nimrod was a mighty hunter of souls. You're a rebellious person. He rebelled against the word of God. He was a type of the Antichrist. He built the kingdom of Babel. He built the Tower of Babel. Amen. The beginning of his kingdom was Babel. Amen. And we see the Bible talks of Babylon. Amen. And in Revelation talks of mystery Babylon. Amen. Amen. We want to read 2 Thessalonians. Paul says, first 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, chapter 2, amen. Says, now we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, and by our gathering together unto him. Amen. The word of God gathers us, amen. That's why it's important that we study the word of God. The Bible says, where two or three are gathered together in the name of Yeshua, HaMashiach, the Lord Jesus Christ, that Yeshua is in our midst, amen. So, we are united when we worship God in spirit and in truth, amen. And Yeshua is in our midst, amen. Verse 2 says, that you be not soon shaken in mind or be troubled, amen. Satan wants to shake your mind and trouble you, amen. Amen. Look at the serpent in the Garden of Eden in Genesis chapter 3. Amen. The devil's tactic was to get Eve to shift her position of faith in the word of God to a position of doubting the word of God. And here Paul is saying in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 2, that you be not soon shaken in mind or be troubled, neither by spirit nor by word nor by letter as from us, as that day of Christ is at hand. Because Paul, being a prophet, being an apostle, he knew the devil's tactics, just like how the devil deceived and corrupted the mind of Eve in the Garden of Eden. That the devil would try and corrupt the minds of the believers in the end times. Amen. Amen. Friend, that's why it's so important to have a revelation from God. It's so important to walk by faith and not by sight. You cannot have confidence in man-made dogmas. You cannot have confidence in man-made creeds. You cannot have confidence in man-made teachings. You cannot have confidence in man-made dogmas and beliefs, amen, that are contrary to the word of God. Amen. You find Adam and Eve, when they realized they were naked, they covered themselves with fig leaves. But God rejected that fig leaf religion of Adam and Eve. Every man-made religion is rejected by God, amen. People might say, oh, there's many roads that lead to Rome. Friend, there might be many roads that lead to Rome, but there's only one way to heaven. There's only one way to God. And Yeshua, HaMashiach, the Lord Jesus Christ, is the way, the truth, and the life. Amen. No man cometh unto the Father but through him. Amen. That's what Yeshua said. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Amen. He is the door. Amen. Hallelujah. He is the right way to God. Amen. Hallelujah. You can't roam your way into heaven. No. Many roads might lead to Rome, but friend, you cannot roam your way into heaven. R-O-A-M. Roam into heaven. There's only one way to God. Amen. That you be not soon shaken in mind or be troubled, neither by spirit nor by word, nor by letters from us, as that day of Christ is at hand. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come, except it come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. Amen. Friend, look at the religious world. A person professing to be representing everything true and holy, everything of God, and then you look at the organization that they head, amen, and you find the Bible says that Babylon has become a cage of every unclean bird. So many scandals, amen. So much stories of financial corruption, sexual scandals, amen. And we find that, amen, there's a saying that says, if the head of the fish is corrupt, then the whole fish is corrupted. Amen. So here we are in 2 Thessalonians. It says, chapter 2, verse 4, who opposed and exalted himself above all that is called God or that is worshipped, so that he as God sitting in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. Remember you not that when I was yet with you, I told you these things, and now you know what withholdeth that he might be revealed in his time. For the mystery of iniquity doth already work, for only he would now letteth or let until he be taken out of the way. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming, even him whose coming is after the working of Satan with all power and signs and lying wonders. Amen. A religious person, amen, deceiving the people with all signs, power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivable business and unrighteousness in them that perish, because they received not the love for the truth, that they might be saved. People don't want to be saved. They want to be entertained. Friend, there's a difference between being saved and being entertained. Amen. People want to walk in the lust of their flesh. They want the lust of the eyes to appeal to them, because they're full of the pride of life. Amen. But friend, we need to repent. Amen. The Bible says, and for this cause God shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie and be damned. Amen. Look how so many people have been deceived around the world. Amen. By false prophets, by false teachings, false religions. Amen. The Bible says, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 11, and for this cause God shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie, that they might all be damned who believe not the truth, but they had pleasure in unrighteousness. See, Bible says, a woman that lives in pleasure is dead while she lives. Amen. You cannot, the Bible says that if you love the things of the world, the love of the Father is not in you. Amen. You are spiritually dead. Amen. So those that, the Bible says that they all might be damned who believe not the truth, but they had pleasure in unrighteousness. But we are bound to give thanks always to God for you, brethren, beloved of the Lord, because God hath from the beginning chosen you. Amen. Predestination. God hath from the beginning chosen you. Because God hath from the beginning chosen you to salvation through sanctification of the Spirit and belief of the truth, whereunto he called you by our gospel to the obtaining of the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, brethren, stand fast. Don't be shaken, amen. Don't be shaken by false teachings. Don't be deceived by enticing spirits, amen. Don't come under a spirit of strong delusion. Have a love for the truth, amen. Whereunto he called you by our gospel to the obtaining of the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, brethren, stand fast and hold the traditions which you have been taught, whether by word or our epistle. Amen. The traditions of the faith, the original faith, not man-made traditions, but traditions received by revelation of the word of God. Amen. Amen. Praying in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, the Lord Jesus Christ. Being baptized the correct way, water baptism. Taking communion, and amen, with a clean heart, not having any grudge against anyone. Amen. Living right, walking right, doing right. Amen. Living a life worthy of the gospel. Amen. Amen. Not speaking evil of your neighbor. Blessing your enemies. Amen. Bless those that persecute you. Amen. Forgiving your enemies. Amen. Praying one for another. Amen. Hallelujah. Following peace with all men and holiness without which no man shall see God. Amen. Amen. And it says in verse 16, now our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God, even our Father, which hath loved us and hath given us everlasting consolation and good hope through grace, comfort your hearts and establish you in every good word and work. Amen. Amen. God wants us to be established in the faith, to be rooted and grounded in Christ Jesus, not in a denomination, not in an organization, but in the resurrected Christ. Amen. Living right, walking right, doing right. Paul said, I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I. And the life that I now live in the flesh, I live by the grace of God, who loved me and died for me. Amen. God bless you, saints. Amen. Stay blessed in Yeshua's name. God bless you. Amen.